Welcome back guys, this is Nandita Kothari and you're on my channel, Nandita Kothari. Welcome back! So if you have ever traveled to South Korea or you have studied abroad in South Korea, you might probably already have visited or you already know about the area called Sincheon. Sincheon in Seoul is located in the southern western part of Seoul above the Han River, and it is popularly known as the university area because it has the four big universities very close to each other: Yonsei University, Ewha Women's University, Hongi University and Sogang University. And it is known for its energetic vibes and the nightlife, the shopping streets, all of that is the present Sincheon. But a lot of people know the history of Sincheon or how Sincheon came to be as it is today. Sincheon is made up of two words. So Shin means new and Cheon means village or a town. So it basically translates to new town. So it is not a proper name like Hongdae or Gangnam. Those are the names of just those areas, but Sincheon is a common noun. So there are a lot of different Sincheons in Seoul, which is basically a lot of new towns in Seoul. But the Sincheon that we talk about is the Sincheon Dong. Dong means neighborhood. So in Korea, the administrative divisions are basically like province, which is the state. Each province has Taekpyeolsi, so special cities, or Si, cities. And each city is then again divided into khus, which are districts in English. Every khu has then neighborhoods, which are followed by the letter dong. So Sincheon is basically Sincheon Dong, which falls under the Seodaemun Gu district. So when we think about Sincheon, we are actually thinking about a lot of different neighborhoods in the Seodaemun Gu district. The Joseon Dynasty lasted from 1392 till 1910. So the Sincheon area already existed since the Joseon Dynasty. In the Joseon Dynasty, Haryun, he wanted to make Sincheon, the area that we're talking about, the capital of the country. But so he did this whole campaign to select Sincheon as the new capital of the country. But sadly, it did not work out, and Hanyang was actually the capital of the country at that time. The area used to be called Sae-tho-mal, which is a pure Korean word and it means new village or new town. But later the word was changed to Sincheon. So Sincheon basically is derived from Hanjeong. So in the Joseon Dynasty, Sincheon was basically just a quiet rural area situated on the outskirts of the Hanyang capital area. So it was the gateway between Hanyang and the western part of the city. From 1910 till 1945, South Korea was under Japanese colonial rule. So the Japanese colonial period had a great influence on the development of Sincheon. In this period, there were a lot of urban planning projects that were taken under, which gave birth to the Sincheon-yeok, which is the Sincheon station. Yonsei University and Ewha University were relocated to the present location where they are. And there were a series of housing projects. So all this happened during the Japanese colonial period, and it greatly influenced the development of the whole Sincheon area. Because of all these developments, Sincheon kind of moved from being just a quiet rural area to become a central part of the city. In 1945, South Korea got independence from the Japanese colonial rule, but then the Korean War started between North Korea and South Korea. So during that time, there was a lot of influx of refugees and residents to the Sincheon area. In the 1980s, there was a huge development in the transport system in whole of Seoul. And in 1984, the line number 2, the green line of the metro that we use today a lot, was launched in 1984. So that kind of made a huge shift in the transport, in the transportation, and Sincheon station became a huge transit area, a transit station for all the people of Seoul. So now during that time, all the big universities were there, and the area was starting to get the reputation as the university area, and it kind of became a residential area filled with students and common people. So that is how the area kind of transformed. So the four big universities in the area, Ewa University or Ewa Women's University, was established in 1886. And it was the country's first women-only university. The second is Yonsei University or Yonsei Daihakyo, which is one of the three sky universities. And it was established in 1885, so like more than 100 years ago. And then the third is Hongik University or Hongik Daihakyo, which is famous for its architecture and art programs. And it was established in 1946. And the newest university among all the four is Sogang University, where I am going. And it was established in 1960, and it is one of the top liberal arts universities. So these four universities are all in the same area, in like in the radius of, I think, 2 kilometers. And that's why this area became an important hub for students and artists, and it became an experimental kind of hub. There was a huge young population who were open to Western culture and were curious about the Western culture. So Sincheon kind of became the experimental ground for new companies who wanted to enter the South Korean market. Sincheon was actually the area where the companies like Krispy Kreme, Tosum Place, Mr. Pizza, all these big chains that we now see everywhere in South Korea, they opened their first shops in Sincheon just to test the market, and if that would become successful, only then they would expand to the rest of the country. So Sincheon became the center of experimenting. Marketing experts used to call Sincheon an indicator for business success. So Sincheon became a central part of the alternative culture in South Korea. So there were a lot of underground music scenes happening, a lot of live music cafes, a lot of literary clubs, and Sincheon had become a fashion hub at that point. You can see the fashion street near the Ewa Women's University, and that area became the fashion hub of the country. It became very important area for the local artists, local musicians, writers and movie producers and all the creative people. So that is how important this area was for the pop culture of South Korea. Sincheon area also played a very important role in the democratization of the country. The country was kind of under a dictator rule. The university students from Yonsei University played a very strong role in the democratization process of the country. They would do a lot of protests and demonstrations on the streets. There were a lot of conflicts with the police, with the government. Sincheon became a very important area for the revolution of the Korean politics. So one of the biggest buildings that you might see in Sincheon is the Hyundai Baekhwajeom, which is the Hyundai Mall. It is situated at the Sincheon Rotary area. So in the Joseon Dynasty, Sincheon area was basically an area where a lot of business and trade used to happen. So in the year 1937, under the land regeneration project, the Sincheon Sijang, which is the Sincheon market, was established, and in 1956 the whole market was privatized. So it became a very important economic location. Till 1979 it was still Sijang, a market, so there was no big building by the time. But then after that, under the first project of the city planning that the government did, the Sijang, the market, was converted into a department store or a mall, a big building, which was called the Grace Baekhwajeom, a Grace department store. And that in 1998 eventually became the Hyundai Baekhwajeom, or Hyundai department store. So Sincheon had its ups and downs, and had its protests, had its revolution, had its peak of economic and popular culture. But sadly, in the last couple of years, Sincheon has been overshadowed by the newer areas like Hongdae and Itaewon, seeing this decline in popularity. So the government has been doing a lot of urban regeneration projects in the area to revive the popularity of Sincheon. So that is the area, the Shincheon area that we all go to. I hope you learned something new today, and I'll be back again next week with another video about another area of Seoul. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you have not already done it. Hit the like button if you like the video. So let me know what is your favorite place to go in Shincheon. Put it in the comment box, and I'll see you next time. Bye!